Dolores, fight the Tulo, Hammond, met in the center. Look, Kenwood, old Sykes, might know him a call. Look, Haven, West, the Hazel, where Crystal Spring. Hell bound the Jackson, the Turkey River, and looks and Madison Canton. Bond, second judgment, dear aunt, wine on a Grenada. Side is mental, dies, bud, fool, and a kilo, Carpenter. Sun, Trevor, Effingham, that tomb, champagne, Jackson, Chicago. Train on track 4, South Emma 2.
I landed in this country a year and a month ago. To make my living at laboring work to the railroad I did go. I shoveled and picked in a big clay bank. I'm merely cheered as same. But my work is yours, you plainly see. I'm the boss of the section gang. Then look at Mike Cahooley, a politician now, whose name and fame he does maintain, and to whom all people bow. I'm the walking boss of the whole railroad, for none I care or deign. My name is Mike Cahooley, and I'm the boss of the section gang. When the railroad president comes round, he takes and shakes my hand. Cahooley, you're tough, you bet you the stuff, you're an honest working man. They never shirk when you're at work, nor at the boss rules line. They shrink with fear when I am near, I'm the boss of the section gang. Then look at Mike Cahooley, it's the last of him you'll see. For I must go to my darling wife, and it's happy we will be. Come one and all, come great and small, and give the door a bang. And you'll be welcome, surely, by the boss of the section gang.
You see old Jerry in the winter time when the fields are white with snow, with his old soldier coat buckled round his throat, to the section he would go. To work all day in the boiling sun or in the storms of snow. And it's while the boys were a-chimmin' up the ties, oh, it's Jerry, will you while the care?
God told Nora by the rainbow sign, no more water but it's fire next time. Hey boys, change your line. Hey boys, just a hair. Hey boys, change your line. Hey boys, just a hair. All right, we're moving on up the giant ahead. Come, keep a hauling by the giant ahead. Ain't said nothing about the hog and bread. Hey boys, change your line. Hey boys, just a hair. Oh boys, line him over. Hey, boy, just a half. Well, we're moving on down to center head. Come, keep a hauling about down ahead. Ain't said nothing about the bull and bread. Hey, boy, change your line. Hey, boy, just a half. Old boy's line him over. Hey, boy, just a half. Old soul, let's move here, children. All right, is you right? Yes, you're right. Going to town, gonna hurry back. See Corina when she bought her jack. Hey boys, change your line. Hey boys, just a hair. All right, Kevin, keep a hauling by the town ahead. All right, children, will you move? Move on down, whole soul. Is you right, children? Yes, we right. Going to town, gonna hurry back. See Corina when she bought her jack. Hey boys, change your line. Oh boys, just a hair.
I've been a-working 10 years on the hill and in railroad. I can't make enough money for to pay my board. I went to the boss, I asked him for my time. Oh, why do you think he told me I owed him one dime? Oh, roll on, buddy, and make up your time. I'm so weak and hungry, I can't make mine. I looked at the sun, and the sun looked was long. I looked at my woman, and she said, don't go. Oh, some of these days, you'll look for me, and I'll be gone back to Tennessee. Yeah, some of these days, you'll call my name, and I'll be gone on an old freight train. I looked at the sun, and the sun looked high. I looked at my woman, she began to cry. Oh, roll on, buddy, don't roll so slow. I'm so weak and hungry, I can't work no more.
Come on, you jolly railroad men, and I'll sing you if I can of the trials and tribulations of a godless railroad band. Started out from Denver, his fortunes to make grow, and struck the Oregon short line way out in Idaho, way out in Idaho, way out in Idaho, a working on the narrow gauge way out in Idaho. I was roaming around in Denver one luckless rainy day when Kilpatrick's man catcher stepped up to me and did say, I'll lay you down $5 as quickly as I can, and you'll hurry up and catch the train, she's starting for Cheyenne. He laid me down $5 like many another man, and I started for the depot, was happy as a clam. When I got to Pocatello, my troubles began to grow, wading through the sagebrush in frost and rain and snow. When I got to American Falls, it was there I met Fat Jack. They said he kept a hotel in a dirty canvas shack. Said he, you are a stranger, and perhaps your funds are low. Well, yonder stands my hotel tent, the best in Idaho. I followed my conductor unto his hotel tent, and for one square and hearty meal I paid him my last cent. Jack's a jolly fellow, and you'll always find him so, working on the narrow gauge way out in Idaho. They put me to work next morning with a cranky cuss called Bill, and they give me a 10-pound hammer to strike upon a drill. They said if I didn't like it, I could take my shirts and go, and they'd keep my blankets for my board way out in Idaho. Oh, it filled my heart with pity as I walked along the track to see so many old bombers with their turkeys on their backs. They said the work was heavy and the grub they couldn't go around Kilpatrick's dirty tables way out in Idaho. But now I'm well and happy down in the harvest camp, and I'll there I will continue till I make a few more stamps. I'll go down to New Mexico and I'll marry the girl I know, and I'll buy me a horse and buggy and go back to Idaho. Way out in Idaho, way out in Idaho, a working on the narrow gauge way out in Idaho.
Oh, I'm a jolly Irish lad, no Shinnessy is me name. I hired out in Section 3 to go winding on the train. Oh, they sent me out to number 10, 'twas there my duties did begin. But where in the devil they all come in, it nearly racked me brain. Oh, they sent me out on the upper deck, 'twas there I thought I'd break me neck. I hung into the ringbolts till me hands and feet grew lame. I could no longer stand upon me pins, 'twas then I thought of all me sins. And if God'll forgive me, I'll never again go winding on the train. Oh, they wanted me to turn a switch, and I fired two boxcars in the dish, and the brakie called me a son of a witch while winding on the train.
Oh, yes, I'm getting old, dear Joe, and never can hope again to take my place on the engine deck and pull out the lightning train. It needs a younger head, I know, and a steadier hand than mine to carry the many precious lives in safety o'er the line. More than 30 years of my life, dear Joe, has been spent on the iron rail. I've had my share of the danger too, yet never was known to quail. I sometimes thought my time had come, though I seldom felt a fear. For you know they used to reckon me a first-class engineer. I never forget that awful night while running the Thunder Joe, that Christmas Eve near the Elgin Branch. Whew, didn't it blow and snow? I could not see the winding track, nor neither the driver's turn. The night was pitchy dark, Joe, and our headlight wouldn't burn. I felt a strange and sudden fear as we ran across the field. My heart beat wild as we neared the bridge just beyond the gravel hill, when suddenly the sterling light gleamed down along the track, and I shouted, "Jump for your life, Joe," and I pulled the lever back. I'll never forget that awful shock, and it makes my blood run cold as I hear again the wintry air, the bells both engines toll. They toll for the dying engineer underneath the sterling deck. They toll for the many precious lives that went out in that awful wreck. They are tolling now in this heart of mine for my darling, my only child. Oh, God, when I saw her fearful fate, no wonder that I was wild. When I saw her lying cold and dead with a smile upon her brow, a smile that I often see, dear Joe, when I think of my darling now. I never forget just what she said last time I took her hand. Goodbye, Papa, till we meet somewhere. I didn't just understand, but it always seemed to me, dear Joe, since I lost my little lamb, as though the angels were watching me, and she was one of them. But now I'm forever laid aside, and will open the valves no more. But I'll watch and wait for the sound of the bell from the train on the other shore. Though old and crippled, they'll put me on board, and the run'll be quick, dear Joe. And I'll meet my long-lost child again, the darling that loved me so.
Long come out every piece we put on the line. Traveling over that CNO road 20 minutes behind the time. He pulled in at Southernville headquarters. taking off strict orders from a station just behind. When he got to London, his engineer was there. His name was Georgie Allen, with his curly golden hair. His fireman, Jack Dixon, was standing by his side, waiting for his orders and in his cab to ride. Along come George's mama with a bucket on her arm. Be careful, George, my darling son, be careful how you run. If you run your engine right, you will get there just on time. Been a many a man who's lost his life by trying to make lost time. Oh, mother, I know your advice is good, and later I'll take heed. But my old engine, she's all right, I'm sure that she will speed. Oh, this road I mean to go with a speed unknown to all. When I blow my whistle at the old stockyard, it better heed my call. Old Georgie says to his fireman Jack, there's a rock ahead I see. Oh, there's death waiting to receive both you and me. Oh, from his engine you must go, your darling life to save. I want you to be an engineer when I'm sleeping in my grave. Oh, says George, that won't do if you are staying dying. Oh, says George, that won't do, I'll die for both you and I. From his engine Jack did go, the river was rolling high. He waved his hand at Georgia as a runaway train dashed by. Down the track she darted, against the rock she crashed. And she turned upside down on Georgie's tender breast. The doctor hastened to him, said, George, my son, lie still. The only hope that would be for your life, it would be God's holy will. His head was lying in firebox door while the burning flames rolled on. Faces covered up in blood, his eyes you could not see. The last word said, poor Georgie said, what am I got to be?
On a dark and stormy night, the rain was falling fast. The two black trains on the southern road with a screaming whistle blast were speeding down the line for home and Christmas Day. On the royal farm in the Ponce de Leon, his laughter bright and gay. Then coming round the curve, 40 miles an hour, the royal farm was making time amid the drenching showers. There came a mighty crash, the two great engines met, and in the minds of those who live, it seemed they can't forget. It was an awful sight, amidst the pouring rain, the dead and dying lying there beneath that mighty train. No tongue can ever tell, no pen can ever write, no one will know but those who saw the horrors of that night. On board the new great train, folks were bright and gay, when like a flash the master called, they had no time to pray. Then in a moment's time, that awful work was done, and many souls that fatal night had made their final run. There's many a saddened home since that sad Christmas day, whose loved ones never shall return to drive their gloom away. They were on the royal palm as she sped across the state. Without a single warning cry, they went to meet their fate. We're on the road of life, and like the railroad men, we each should do our best to make the station if we can. So let us all take care to keep our orders straight, for if we get our orders mixed, it'll surely be too late.
Thank you. train's off the track, and I can't get it back, and I can't get a letter to my home. To my home, to my home, and I can't get a letter to my home. If you say so, I'll railroad no more, I'll sidetrack my train and go home. And go home, and go home, I'll sidetrack my train and go home. If you like me like I like you, we'll both like the same. Come on, my love, this very day, I'd like for to change your name. Your name, your name. Oh, I'd like for to change your name.
I lay my head down on some railroad line. I lay my head down on some railroad line. And it takes some train to satisfy my mind. Honey, when I die, honey, don't you wear no black. Honey, when I die, honey, don't you wear no black. Then if you do, my ghost comes sneaking by. Yonder come the train, yonder come the train, coming down the railroad line. Yonder come the train, yonder come the train, coming down the railroad line. Hey, coming too, buddy. It takes some train to satisfy my mind. My mama told me, my daddy told me too. Says, son, everybody grinning your face, you ain't no friend to you. That's all.
I've rode a feather and I've rode a Atlantean. I've rode a southern.
Express from the depot one night.
has started out on its way. And all the people that boarded that train, they seem to be happy and gay. Except a little boy sat on a seat by himself, a reading a letter he had. It is plain to be seen from the tears in his eyes. His condense is what made him sad. The strange conductor, he started his train and taken the tickets of everyone there. And when he reached the side of the boy, he bravely commanded his fare. I've got no money to pay my way, but I'll pay you back someday. I'll put you off at the next station, says he. These words the boy did say. Oh, please, Mr. Conductor, don't put me off of this train. For the only friend that I ever had is waiting for me in pain. Expecting her to die every moment, and may not live through the day. I won't kiss mother goodbye, sir, before God takes her away. Mother was sick when I left home and needed a doctor's care. I come to your city employment for work, but couldn't find none anywhere.
Have you ever heard about that railroad ride?
railroader's bride I'll be. I would not marry a blacksmith, he's always in the black. But I would marry an engineer who pulls the throttle back. A railroader mother, a railroader for me. If ever I marry in all my life, a railroader's bride I'll be. I left Beard one beautiful night. The stars in the heavens were shining bright. I was riding the bumpers which suited me fine, much better than the handouts on the TMP line. I landed in Welford about 3 p.m. The cops watched me and I watched him. I made him no effort, I give him no sign that I had been bumming on the TMP line. I decided to dress up in style, not look like a bummer, no, not by a mile. Rare back on my budget, give each man a dime, and that would be bumming on the TMP line. A $10 suit and a $5 hat, a high-standing collar and a flying cravat. A new pair of boots, how the leather did shine, much better than the handouts on the TMP line. I met up with a man by the name of Will Wright. He says, I will hire you if you will work right. Well, I will work right and put in good time, much better than the handouts on the TMP line. I got in the wagon and home with him went. The work he gave me, God to me had sent. The work, it was easy and it suited me fine, much better than the handouts on the TMP line. Will Wright had a daughter at the age of 16, the fairest and prettiest that ever I seen. And when I was with her, I was always on time, much better than the handouts on the TMP line. Me and Ethel begin to chat. I help gather eggs, do this and do that. Her kisses were sweet and her features was fine, much better than the handouts on the TMP line. I was called to the office, one day. Will Wright says, why sis, I hear the folks say. They say you're a bummer all dressed up for blind, that you have been bumming on the TMP line. Well, I don't know as that concerns you. I do all the work you require me to do. If my work it don't suit you, just give me my time and I'll remain bumming on the TMP line. I went by the house to bid Ethel farewell. The grief and the sorrow no tongue can ne'er tell. There were tears in her eyes and so were in mine. She said, you're no bummer on the TMP line. I struck out right down the highway. I could think of nothing but Ethel that day. I love her till yet and I'll see her sometime if I have to bum my way on the TMP line.
My name's George Lay. I picked up this song along with several others in the hobo jungles in the late 30s. When we was trying to scramble around over the country and find a dime, which is hard to do, and it's a lot harder to keep it after you found it. There's a lot of guys along there that the ink was still wet on diplomas from their colleges, and there's a lot of guys that had never been inside of the school. About the only entertainment we had was these old songs at night. I don't know what the name of this one is. It's just one they used to sing a lot. Just out of San Francisco, one cold December day, beneath an eastbound boxcar, a dying hobo lay. His comrade stood beside him, his hat was in his hand, for he knew that his old buddy was going to a distant land. Go tell my girl in Frisco, no longer will I roam. I've caught an eastbound boxcar, and I'm on my way back home. I'm going to a better land where you don't have to change your socks, where beer and foam come trickling down the rocks. The dying hobo closed his eyes and drew his last breath. His comrade stole his coat and hat and kept on heading west.
One evening as the sun went down and the jungle fire was burning, down the track came a hobo hiking. And he said, boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed for a land that's far away, beside the crystal fountains. So come with me, we'll go and see the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, there's a land that's fair and bright, where the handouts grow on bushes, and you sleep out every night. Where the boxcars all are empty, and the sun shines every day, on the birds and the bees and the cigarette trees and the lemonade springs, where the bluebird sings in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, all the cops have wooden legs, and the bulldogs all have rubber teeth, and the hens lay soft-boiled eggs. There the farmer's trees are full of fruit, and the barns are full of hay. And I'm bound to go where there ain't no snow, and the rain don't fall, and the wind don't blow, in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, you never change your socks, and the little streams of alcohol come a-trickling down the rocks. There ain't no short-handled shovels, no axes, spades, or picks, and I'm bound to stay where they sleep all day, where they hung the Turk that invented work, in the Big Rock Candy Mountains. In the Big Rock Candy Mountains, all the jails are made of tin, and you can walk right out again as soon as you are in. Why, the brakemen have to tip their hats, and the railroad bulls are blind. There's a lake of stew and a gin lake too, you can paddle all around them in a big canoe, in the Big Rock Candy Mountains.
Get right, Churchill, let's go home. Get right, Churchill, let's go home. Get right, Churchill, get right, Churchill. Get right, Churchill, let's go home. I'm going home on a morning train. I'm going home on a morning train. I'm going home.
I'm going home on a morning train.